One of the most important things I've learned over the years is quite simply, you can get pars from absolutely anywhere. So never give up trying. You might not get it, but you'll certainly not get it if you give up.
Well, hello again. Another Friday night dash after work. So what's this video about? Well, quite simply, I am doing far too much at the moment. I'm spinning far too many plates. You know, I'm trying to practice, I'm trying to play casual golf, I'm trying to play golf with my sons, I'm trying to compete, I'm trying to make videos, I'm trying to edit, and I'm trying to do a little bit on my railway every now and then, which just isn't happening at the moment. So I'm going to be letting some of those plates drop. And quite simply, while the golf courses are hard and bouncy, before the weather or the wind turns around to the southwest and brings us some rain in, I don't see the point of competing because I can't shoot my handicap. I played the other day at a course and my ball striking's been getting better. Well, apart from my couple of opening drives being shoved out to the right, but my game's been getting better and I hit 14 greens in regulation. So I should have scored really well. The only trouble is that 10 of those went charging through the back into the rubbish. And I lost a couple of balls. So what should have been an excellent round and probably better than my handicap turned into garbage. So I believe the rain is due in on Sunday, Monday, and until then, until the golf courses soften up, I'm not going to have any away days and I'm not going to play any comps. So until then, I can concentrate on other things. Just let a fast single through. Just going to let another fast single through. As I say, when I am up filming, I'm the least important person on the golf course. So I might as well let them go. Let them enjoy their evening and I'll enjoy mine.
So as the man said, I'm simply trying to do too much. When you try to do too much, you don't do anything particularly well. So it's better to concentrate on a lesser number of things and do better.
I've played a number of courses recently and they're all the same. You hit something into the green and it just doesn't stop. But if you try and play it short, you're obviously bringing the front bunkers into play, which is a big no-no. So scoring is very difficult. Now, I played on Monday with Golf Psychic at the Rolls of Monmouth. The greens were absolutely lightning. And of course, they've got great big slopes on them. And I had a fault. I was thinning it. I knew what the fault was, I just couldn't fix it on the golf course. Obviously, you can see now, I've fixed it a couple of days later. So yeah, I could just keep playing competitions and let my handicap rise. I'd get up to a 6. Who knows, I might even get to a 7. But I don't want to do that, you know. I don't want my handicap to go up when I'm striking the ball well. If it goes up because I can't hit my hat, so be it. But if I'm hitting the ball well, no thank you.
One of the things that has changed for me since I had a lesson with Matt is I am starting to draw the ball. And I'm having to learn to aim a little bit further right than I normally would. That time it didn't pay off, because it's not 100% yet. But we're getting there.
It's always nice to see the ball bounce there instead of splash.
I've also added about 4 miles an hour on my 7-iron club speed. So that's making a difference through the bag to how far I carry the ball through the air. And it's another adjustment I'm trying to make. Talking of adjustments, now the ground is firming up on 6, I'm having to aim a fair bit further right than I have been in the past. Although that time I overdid it a fraction. And you have to be aware of the changing conditions. So with the ground firm, all I need here is a 3-wood. Gets a little bit tight up there with a driver. You know, add another 20-30 yards to this, and I can get into all sorts of bother. Mind you, I can get into all sorts of bother by hitting my sand wedge 100 yards, which is, under normal circumstances, completely impossible. But there you go. That's golf at the moment. Well, I finally got fed up of hitting an iron into this north wind. So it's out with Mr. Boom Boom. This is what I call a safe gamble. If I get it right, I'm on for a birdie. If I get it wrong, like this, because the ball was a bit below my feet and I hit it real bottom groove, then I'm on for a par. There's no real penalty for hitting that second shot poorly. So I see it as a safe gamble. Downwind, firm green, I don't stand a chance. Not the best drive I've ever hit down here. If I can land this on the front, then I have a chance of holding the back. And we more or less managed to do it. Well, as you can see, this plays about 185 yards. causing to the laser. So I am going to go 4-iron. That is a really good one.
Well, I did get up here with my 4-iron, but I have no idea where it is. I can only presume that it's shot across the green and it's in this heavy stuff behind me. I've had a look all round, can't see it. I even went for a little peek in the hole, because you never know, it might have run round this slope and back into the hole, but it's gone. Bugger.
Well, that 9-iron sat down, which has left me a long way back. But it's no real bother, I'm just grateful that it did sit down, and I can 2-putt it. Now the wind is slowly changing direction, it's slowly quartering back towards the southwest. And a few days after this, it really did turn around, and it's changed the character of the golf course completely. It's no longer going to be 5-iron, 5-iron up here. I'm going to have to hit a hybrid and a 5-iron, or a hybrid and a 4-iron. I'm actually looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to the golf course playing more what I'm used to playing.
Well, I made it.
This north wind for 3 or 4 weeks has been quite confusing for me. Now we've got thunder and rain. So hopefully I'm going to be getting a lot closer to the flag with my wedges. Then I can start shooting scores that I feel I should be shooting from the white tees instead of the garbage that I am shooting. 62, sand wedge, into the breeze, can't stop it. So yeah, there's definitely potential for me to play and shoot much lower scores, given half a chance.
Well, sun is going down, I don't know what time it is. Plenty of time to finish anyway. I'm pretty pleased with where I'm hitting the ball. In fact, I'd go as far to say that I'm hitting the ball better than my handicap. But I'm scoring considerably worse than my handicap. Problem I have is doubt. Whether it's a driver or a pitching wedge, if I don't know where the ball is going to finish, then it fills my head with doubt. And then when I've run off the side of a green or the back of a green, I'm full of doubt. I don't know how hard the ball's going to bounce, how much is it going to run out. So you find yourself, instead of having 15 feet for a bird and a tap in par if you miss, I got 15 feet for a par. And I really can't play golf like this. So as I say, for the moment, competitions can go on the back burner, but let's enjoy the evening. Let's see if I can finish with 3 pars. I mean, I've had so many bogeys tonight and virtually none of them have been my fault, really. That's the grim thing. is so many of these bogies are not my fault. Ta-ra!
Said when the ground firms up, if you can drive this down the left side of the fairway, he'll get to the bottom. All you gotta do is hit it in the right direction. A bit like that. Ta-ra!